students, once again we are back to our grammar section. In our last class we discussed about different types of sentences and reported speech. Do you remember it? Yes, okay. Today let's revise sentence. How can we define it? Yes, it's a group of words that makes a complete sense. Example, Mary is a good girl. Sentences can be divided into two parts, subject and predicate. What's a subject? Yes, a subject is a part of sentence that names a person or a thing we are talking about. Example, he is waiting for me outside. Which is a subject here? No doubt, he. No, because the subject is the name of something which is said in the sentence. He is waiting for me outside. What does it mean? It is a predicate here. Predicate is that part of a sentence that gives some information about the subject. Okay, now look at the next one. We are going to play cricket. What are the things you can see here? A sentence, subject, predicate, article, noun, verb, etc. So from this we can understand we are going to know more about sentences. What's a phrase? We had already learned that a phrase is a group of words but does not make a complete sense. It is a part of a sentence. Now, let's see two types of phrases here. Noun phrase and verb phrase. What is noun phrase? A group of words that contains a naming word or a noun is called a noun phrase, and a group of words that contains a verb is called a verb phrase. Let's go through some of the examples of noun phrase and verb phrase. Green grass covered the field. Find out the noun here. Yes, grass and field are the nouns in the sentences, naming words. Now tell me the noun phrase here. Yes, green grass, the field is a noun phrase in the sentence. Now see the subject and predicate. Can you identify? Yes, green grass is a subject and covered the field is a predicate here. Now let's move to the next example. All the friends of Annie love chocolate. Here, which is a subject and which is a predicate? Yes, all the friends of Annie is a subject and love chocolate is a predicate. Look at the noun phrase here. All the friends of Annie is a noun phrase and love chocolate is a verb phrase. Look at the next example. The things lying on the table are looking untidy. Things lying on the table is a noun phrase and the subject are looking untidy is a predicate and the verb phrase here. So I hope it's clear for you. Now, there can be multiple verb in a single verb phrase. Example, this table can be lifted with the help of two more people. So this table is a subject here. Can be lifted with the help of two more people. Two more people is also a subject, noun. So these are the noun phrase here. And can you identify the verb here? Yes, can be lifted is a verb phrase here. And again we can divide the verb phrase into helping verb and main verb. Okay, so again the division is here. I hope you understood. See the next one. The group of girls danced, sang and performed beautifully. So the group of girls is a noun phrase and danced, sang and performed beautifully is a verb phrase. Okay, now let's move on to the activity 1 of our textbook. Okay, read the following sentences from maternity. The child was condemned to die of hunger. So you have to find the subject and the predicate here. You know the sentence is divided into two part and you have to find. I hope you can do it because we had learned in the first unit. Now read the passage below and identify the subject and predicate here. The little child was crying for milk. The little child is a subject or the noun phrase. Was crying for milk is a verb phrase. Mikali has no money in his pocket to buy milk. So Mikali is a subject, the rest is a predicate. No? Likewise, you have to fill this exercise. Look here, in this typical sentences, a noun phrase is immediately followed by a verb phrase. A noun phrase can be a noun or a pronoun or a group of words that does a function of a noun. A verb phrase consists of a helping verb or a main verb which may or may not be followed by another words. Let's split the subject and predicate part of the first sentence. The little child was crying for milk. The noun phrase and the verb phrase here. The noun phrase, the little child, is a noun phrase, and was crying for milk is a verb phrase. The little child, the is a determiner, little is an adjective, and child is a noun here. Was crying for milk. Was crying, again divided into was, is a helping verb. Crying is a main verb. For milk, for is a preposition and milk is a noun. So these are the divisions of a noun phrase and a verb phrase. Now look at the next page. The head word of a noun phrase is a noun, that is child here. The other words are used to give additional information about the head word. Thus, the obligatory element, that is the compulsory element, is a noun phrase, is a noun. Any other elements are optional here. Determiners. Look at the determiners here. Articles, possessive, and demonstratives, which come before a noun, are called determiners. Articles such as a and the, that you are familiar. And possessive, which are the possessives? My, our, your, his, her, their, its, Gandhiji's, etc. Demonstratives like this, that, these, those. The articles, possessive and demonstrative, comes under the term determiners. Now let's have a look at the following sentence. All the women in the camp who saw the child gave vent to cry of horror. Identify the noun phrase and the verb phrase here. Yes, which are the noun phrase here? All the women in the camp who saw the child, that is a noun phrase, and gave is a verb, no? So gave vent to cries of the horror is a verb phrase. I hope you can find the difference between noun phrase and verb phrase here. Now let's go in detail. See the constituents of the noun phrase here. All the women in the camp who saw the child. See the noun phrase here. All the women in the camp who saw the child. All is predeterminer. Predeterminer or pre-articles are those items which come before the determiner in a noun phrase, like half, half of, all of, etc. So determiners we know, no? Articles, possessive and demonstratives are known as determiners, and predeterminers are words that come just before the determiners. So here the is a determiner and all is a predeterminer. Women is a noun, in the camp is a prepositional phrase. In is a preposition and a disproportional phrase. Who saw the child is a relative clause, that also you are familiar. So these are the division of noun phrase in this sentence. So from this we can understand that the structure of a noun phrase of a sentence can be as follow: predeterminer, determiner, adjective, noun, proportional phrase, relative clause, etc. Now look at the table, women. Yes, it's crystal clear that it is a noun. The women shows the is a determiner and women is a noun. All the women, all is a predeterminer, determiner, that noun. All the women in the camp, that is clear for you. And all the women in the camp who saw the child. Who saw the child is a relative clause. So here is an activity for you to do. It's a pair work, but here you can do it individually. Find out other sentences from the passage in the same way and identify the constituents. Okay? Now look at the picture and identify the verb phrase in the sentence given below. The duckling left the pool. Left the pool is a verb phrase here. See the second line? The duckling left the pool in the morning. So left the pool in the morning is a verb phrase. Try to do the rest of the sentences by yourself. Underline the verb phrase here. From the above sentence, we got the verb phrase as left the pool in the morning. Left the pool. Left is a verb phrase and the pool is a noun phrase. In the morning. In the morning is a prepositional phrase. A verb phrase consists of a finite verb alone or a finite verb with some other words which gives additional details about the verb. So there will be a verb and some other words which gives additional details about the verb, and that makes a verb phrase. Okay? Now, try to find out the correct verb phrase and noun phrase from the sentences given before. Yes, verb phrase and noun phrase, which are the sentence that reads, comes a, the fox killed the duckling. Killed is a verb phrase and the duckling is a noun phrase. Look at the next verb, verb phrase and prepositional phrase. Which are the verb phrase and prepositional phrase? Was waiting for its prey. Was waiting is a verb phrase. For its prey. For is a preposition. For its prey is a prepositional phrase. Now see the next one. Verb phrase, noun phrase and prepositional phrase. Took rest at the pond. Took is a verb phrase. Rest is a noun phrase. And prepositional phrase is at the pond. Look at the next one. Verb phrase and noun phrase. Yes, left the pool. Noun is a pool and verb is a left. Last one, verb phrase, noun phrase and prepositional phrase shows that left the pool in the morning. Left is a noun verb phrase, pool is a noun phrase and in the morning is a prepositional phrase. I hope that it's clear for you and try to do all the activities by yourself and underline the phrases properly and understand it. See the last activity of your textbook. Yes, you are asked to make sentences of your own with the following constituents in the verb phrase given below. I hope you can do it by yourself. If there is any doubt related to the topic, you can ask me. See you in the next class.